What would you say your favorite bit is that you guys do?
I like the bits that we do presentations where we're like in a suit and tie. And
they're making the PowerPoint.
Yeah, and we don't know. Like, those are the ones that they're, I never get tired of.
I wanted you. I told you, come to set whenever you want.
I want you so bad.
Next time you come back, make sure it happens. Okay. I didn't know when you got in, when you don't.
We got in at like 2 or 3 this morning because we came from DC.
Yeah.
Dude, it was like $47 in tolls.
So you guys, the three of you were driving together?
Yes.
And are you guys, I know you're probably not going to be dead on this, but are you starting to get sick, a little sick of each other?
The thing is, we're not. Really? That's awesome. A real thing. Yeah. Awesome. So it's funny because a lot of times...
We come from that world.
Yeah. You ride with people out of necessity sometimes, but then since we start trying to do the New Day stuff, and they like essentially let us, we're on all the same shows, so we never have to break up like who's riding with who or anything like that.
So it's easy for you to travel together.
Very. And especially because we're all actually friends, you know what I mean?
Right. So, well, that's what makes our show bearable.
Yeah.
We're like that. We work 7 days a week, and we rip on each other all the time.
Yeah.
So if you didn't have that thing that you have, then it would get bad.
You can like literally feel like the same thing with you guys. We can feel like how much fun you guys are having because you're not forcing it. It's not like, hey, I've got an idea for a show. I'll hire this guy and this guy. You guys get good chemistry. Right. It's like,
well, that's how it is when after I watch. Sometimes I text you like,
yeah.
Just you guys, the lines that you guys say. Are so
do you feel weird when you text them right as like?
Yeah,
because I'll text.
I wait a day.
I feel like a fan a little bit too much, but I get so excited. Anytime Francesca 2 comes out, I'm like, I love this thing. I love it. So I try, but I can't stop myself. I text.
But it's the same thing for me. So I will say the other day, one of my friends said, when we hang out, like all we do is. We get on like on demand and we just watch Impractical Jokers. And so they texted me the other day, and it was after you texted me the Street Fighter stuff.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, what are you doing? I was like, nothing. Just talking to Quinn about Street Fighter.
Like, yeah, it's funny because I'm having you see it right on the other side. I'll be like, I'll go to Jay. I was like, yeah, what are you doing? It's funny, man.
Do you play any other instruments?
I play piano a little bit. I started trying to play guitar. I'm not very good.
You should come out with a piano.
Yeah. WrestleMania.
I'm thinking we do the one-man band thing and have the bass drum and like the harmonica and the cymbals and everything.
Now, I don't know if I'm allowed to ask this, but
do you
travel with Francesca too, or do they hold it for you just so it doesn't get
Francesca
lost?
Francesca too, she stays on the truck because our relationship is very intense.
Right.
And it's very passionate. And if we were around each other all the time, I'd never get anything done. Right? Together like this, and so they had to take away from me.
So you've been asked this question before.
So I have a question, because you guys, really, your popularity, it was, I mean, I know everybody works, you worked your whole career to get to a point, and so it wasn't an overnight success, I understand that.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it went from boom to boom. Like you guys were like,
how? I'm going to add an addendum to that question. Yes. I don't know if that's the right word.
No,
that's a big word. Addendum. So when you guys started with the idea, did you think that idea was going to work?
Yeah. So what happened? And this is weird because we never talk about wrestling stuff, so it's like it's all a first for the show.
Oh, all right.
So,
arrived back, guys.
Yeah! Yeah.
Vampire!
Get it on camera. No, it's
Vampire's
fine.
Vampire's back. Daddies.
My stepsister's back. But to answer your question,
yes.
So when we became like preachers, my thought was we're going to do this because it wants to be super positive. And we live in a very cynical world. I'm a very cynical person because coming from psychology, they told us to be cynics and question everything. So my thought is people don't like people who are doing well for whatever reason.
True.
Everyone is and that's just how we live right now.
You're talking to two.
So the thought in our heads was like, well, if we do this as hard as we can and put like literally everything, heart and soul we have into it, people will take a dump on it because that's how we are right now. But then once that happens, we will be able to make the shift and turn it into something where we are then cynical and shoving it back in people's faces. And if I'm watching wrestling, I think that's hilarious. Right. So we're just doing legit.
So did everybody else.
Yeah. We're legit just doing what we think is funny. Because Jericho, in his book, he says he started wearing like his top ponytail and stuff because it popped him. It made him laugh. I'm like, oh, well, let's just do that. So literally everything we do, like inside jokes from the car and stuff, they just happen while we're talking out there. And like people happen to be into it. So thank you. And
I remember the switch because you guys were going positivity, and then you had that one line where you were like, we're positive this town sucks, and that was it. It was like, boom, suddenly you were on the other side.
I'm just having fun. This is just fun. It's hard to ask questions.
I have like a thousand questions.
Gotcha. Like, when you straightened that hair, was genius.
Oh, yeah. The hair stuff.
You came out with the brush.
Yeah. So funny story about that. My mom texted me, like, later that night, we're in the car, and she goes, first off, when... were you going to tell me that you straightened your hair? Because she told me when I was little, if I ever straightened my hair, she would disown me. Because, like, normally you do it, like, permanently with chemicals and stuff.
Yeah.
And I was like, no, it's not permanent, it's not permanent, it's fine. She's like, okay. Second, where in the hell did you get a brush from? And I was like, I was hiding it in my gear so you could just pull it out.
I'm not taking this.
Oh! This is rough. Do you guys get a chance to, like, relax at all? Because you guys
are doing it right now.
This is relaxing.
We do. I wouldn't change it. I mean,
yeah.
It took a long time to get where we were. So
it might have been a little easier if we were 10 years younger. Like, people, because, you know, we do these shows, and people are. That first hit. And people are like, you're just the worst.
I hit you seven times.
You didn't hit me at all. I took no damage.
Are you using block?
Yeah.
Dude, I didn't know we were doing that.
Do. Look, he's so grateful because he got a flawless victory. If this was Mortal Kombat, I would have ripped out your spine and slapped you across the face with it.
There you go. Oh! One more.
Yeah. You almost had him. I saw that. Fingers
up.
Almost had him.
All time.
I don't understand. Like, I don't, you know.
Were you going to go again?
Yeah, I mean,
you got to get him this time. You get him this time. Okay, there you go. Now get out. Now get out. Back up. Or.
Boom.
See, he has no damage.
There you go.
This is really a Cinderella story.
Got this.
Come back.
You
thank you for your support.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Oh,
this is how we do it.
This is how we do it.
I'm changing my name from Retro to Mark Morris.
Both those matches, I was looking up at the ceiling and just hitting a button.
Oh, jeez.
Footage replay. Oh, wait, Mark Morrison?
Mm-mm.
Mark Morrison didn't sing that
song. Oh, Return of the Mac. This is how we do it.
Who am I going
to kill?
Get it.
Montel Jordan.
You can't be Mark Morrison.
How often do you guys play yourself? I
texted you last week. I was playing you in a Royal Rumble with my nieces.
Yeah. I was like, wow.
I didn't even. Is this where we've gone? I wasn't even telling you. Were you doing that? Were you distracting me? Who are you, Mr. Fiji?
Sounds like I'm inside your skin right now.
Sweep the leg. When we play the wrestling game, it's not weird to play ourselves, but it's way funnier to not play ourselves. So, like, for instance, like Breeze and I are like the reigning tag champs, but we only play as versions of William Regal.
Yeah.
Oh, that's funny. That is funny.
We are the Brothers Regal.
That's good.
Okay, we're going to wrap things up. That was Up, Up, Down, Down.
Sweet.
Thank you to our guests, Impractical Jokers, for being on. Thanks.
Thank you, guys. So,
for Ninja you. Quinn. Yeah. Appreciate it.
Please. Vampire.
Vampire and retro.
Yeah.
And extra large.
So large.
Extra large.
Glampire here. All right, cool. Thank you to everybody. Make sure you follow your boy Austin Creed on Twitter and Instagram at Xavier Woods, PhD. Follow Retro on Twitter at
Sal Volcano.
Follow Hambone.
Hampire
on Twitter at
BQ Quinn.
Follow two Q's. Follow Extra Large on Twitter at
Mid Evenings.
Follow the Glampire on Twitter at
Real Page WWE.
Follow the channel on Instagram and Twitter at UpUpDownDown without the O's. Like, subscribe, share, and no matter the circumstances, make sure that you always and forever keep it tight. And then we let our guests give them a keep it tight, however you want. You can give them a couple times, you can give them one, you can just give it. However,
all right, that's a lot.
Keep it tight.
Yeah. Oh, you did it all cool. Yeah. Anyway, come on. Keep it tight.
That's so creepy.
I was going to put my fist in my mouth and you'll hear it around. There you go.
I want it like this. Keep it.
Yeah.
I'll make that muscle look good. Keep it tight.
I don't need this alpha male. I don't need it.
Sweet. All right, cool. Thanks for watching, guys. Later.